Have you ever noticed when you get a bit of custard on your hand, if you play with it, it becomes very solid, but if you leave it for a while, it will drip off from your hand. Now this idea is known as a non-Newtonian fluid and has been studied by mathematicians for centuries. But new technology makes it appear as though this idea, this clever little bit of fluid dynamics can be used to save lives. Now, most fluids like water, oil, even air are very well behaved. You can write down a set of equations which will predict exactly what they'll be doing at any point in time in the future. But there are some fluids which don't conform to this perfect equation. And these are known as non-Newtonian fluids. They have quirky properties that they change depending on what's going on around them. Now, one type is called shear thinning. And this is ketchup, mayonnaise, and paint. Now, have you noticed with a bottle of ketchup that if you just turn the bottle upside down, all the ketchup is stuck in the bottom of the bottle. But if you give it a good whack, suddenly you can get your ketchup to flow out of the bottle. Now, the whack that you give the bottle is changing the viscosity or the thickness of the fluid of the ketchup and allowing it to flow. It's the same idea with paint. It's why you stir paint before you get going. You can get it as thin on a paintbrush to go and adhere to a wall, but as soon as it's on the wall, it then thickens so that it doesn't drip or you don't get brush marks in the paint. Now, the idea of quicksand is exactly the same. So any mathematician who's looked into the equations of shear thinning fluids will tell you if you get caught in quicksand, you should stay as still as you possibly can, because otherwise any forces that you apply in your movement to the sand around you will turn it into a liquid in exactly the same way that ketchup becomes liquid as you thwack it on the bottom of the bottle. Now, on the other end of the spectrum with these types of fluids are shear thickening fluids. Now, this is like custard, for instance. So instead of when you move custard, when you apply force to custard, rather than it becoming thinner, it becomes thicker and solidifies in your hand as you play with it. Now, this is all very well. It means that certain scientists can run over custard in a swimming pool and do all sorts of experiments like that. But actually, it has a much better application, which has only just recently been realised. Now, this is the same as that special science putty that you can buy from the science museum. You can pull it, you can bend it, you can mould it. If you leave it to sit there, it turns into a puddle, turns into a liquid puddle. But crucially, if you hit it with a hammer, it will suddenly become perfectly solid and shatter into lots of different pieces. Now, it's this property of hitting it and it instantly becoming solid, which allows you to use these fluids in bulletproof vests, for example. Now, if you can imagine a standard bulletproof vest, it's very big, it's very bulky, it's very heavy. They weigh 12 kilos or 25 pounds. It's very difficult to move around in. But if instead you can get this fluid and stitch it into the fabric of a bulletproof vest, it can be much thinner and much lighter, but crucially has the same properties of being able to stop a bullet. As soon as the bullet hits the surface, it will immediately contract and solidify in a thousandth of a second. Now, these bulletproof vests are just being developed at the moment and are shown to be just as good as the original ceramic ones in tests where they fire bullets at 300 meters per second at the target. But if you can imagine that there's a fluid which can be put into the lining of something that's strong enough to stop a bullet, then it changes the way that we can make helmets, for instance, in the future. So if you imagine like a skateboarder or a snowboarder, the helmets that they wear, it sort of restricts their movement. They're quite big, they're quite bulky, and also image is very important to people who are involved in these kind of extreme sports. So certain companies have started stitching this fabric into the lining of beanie hats, which work perfectly as crash helmets for skateboarders and snowboarders. But also, they've started looking into making ballet shoes with this material inside. So ballet shoes, for instance, have had the same design for hundreds of years. And famously, ballet dancers have terrible problems with going on point in these shoes. But instead, if you stitch this putty-like lining into the bottom of the shoes, it can protect the dancer's feet beautifully and offer much more freedom of movement and a much lighter shoe. So, bulletproof vests, beanie hats as crash helmets, and ballet shoes. Turns out there's more to custard than just putting it on your crumble. And if you fancy a sweet treat, you can subscribe to Head Squeeze.
Got a bit of dancing food going on. I'm gonna try this one.